Well, welcome to the Steve Rob Show. Today we're comparing table saws. I bought myself a compact table saw. And there were two choices, Dewalt and Bosch. We're going to get down to why I picked the Bosch over the Dewalt. I'm going to be using this and going to be using this. So let me get this all set up. I'm going to take the saw out of the case, you know, get rid of all the cardboard, put it all together, and then we'll get down to why I bought the Bosch saw over the Dewalt. And it may surprise you exactly why. Now, part of the reason is the amperage. I did phone Dewalt and I did phone Bosch and I asked them. I'm going to be using this table saw up at my camp off my generator. Now my generator is 4,550 watt maximum starting amperage, and that's 38 amps, and it runs at 3550, which is 30 amps, just a little bit under 30 amps. Now, the phone call that I got with Dewalt said that their saw runs at 5,400 watt starting current. And that's 45 amps. And the Bosch, they told me on the phone that the startup current was 2,800 watts, and that is 23 amps well within. So let me get this all straightened out, and we'll take a look, and we'll measure the exact startup current. I'll show you the saw. Let's get to it. Well, I thought I'd show you my big table saw. And of course, this one's going up to my camp, my new one. And this is the saw that I have, and it's just got my guide here, and it's got my push stick, and you know, and it's a great saw. And you notice there's nothing here. So I took all this stuff out of the box over here. I got it all ready to go, and let's take a look at it. Here we go. Okay, so here's the front of the saw here, and it's a. Looks like it's very well laid out, you know, and of course this is, you know, for raising and lower your blade and the pitch of the blade, the angle, and, you know, it's all pretty well the same on most saws. This here, I thought, is a great feature, and this here is your fence. The fence extends, I'll show you that in a second, goes, you move that in and out, and here's your push stick in here, and everything is all self-contained. Everything I'm going to show you here all fits in nice and neat. And what I like about this saw is it's 50 pounds. I can carry it around anywhere. And I am going to do a mod to this very soon. I'll show you that mod. But for now, this is it right here. And this is the nice feature that I like right here is you flip this up and the table extends. You know, guys, and that is sweet right there. That's all I really need for what I'm doing. And this is, you know, a great little idea. And this tightens back down here. And this is your guide that goes across, back and forth. I mean, you know, it's not all heavy duty, but I'll tell you what, it's going to be fine for me. And it tightens at both ends, not just this end. It grabs on the back side there too, which I thought it was pretty neat. And down here, you've got a grab handle that you can hold on to. Very, very nice design. I like this. I mean, it's very simple. Going to be easy for me to carry. And I think it's a sweet little rig. I like it a lot. And everything, like you say, is self-contained. And everything goes in there. Now, there's an option on the back where you can put a dust bag on the back if you want, but I'll be using this outdoors anyway, so I don't mind that. I just may put a 45 degree elbow on that, but besides that, I think it's a pretty sweet rig. Now let me just explain what this is. Okay guys, I'm all for safety, but I don't know what these antlers are stuck on the front of here. I took all this stuff off. It's got doohickeys. It's got stuff here. I don't know if they were planning on cutting wood with this or, you know, trying to trap a bear. I have no idea. I took all the stuff off, guys. I'll tell you what.
I think a lot of this safety gear is great for somebody who's new. You know, and of course, the manufacturers of these saws, they probably get sued all the time for people cutting their fingers off and that kind of stuff. You know, a lot of this is common sense. And to me, I could not work with all that safety gear on. I'd love to hear in the comments if anybody uses a saw like this with all that gear on there. Because I couldn't use it in a million years. I showed you what my old saw looks like. I've been using that for, I guess it's around 30 years I've had that saw, and I got all my fingers and, you know, that kind of stuff. So, yeah, this is, the safety equipment is fantastic for people who are new to the saw and aren't too sure, and I guess, you know, they have to have mandated safety equipment. But for me, I'm quite confident that I can operate this saw safely myself. I'm not saying you to take all the safety gear off or anything like that. That's just what I do. And I think for me, this would be unsafe for me to operate with all that kind of stuff on there, because I can't even see the piece of wood. I can't see my line mark. I couldn't see nothing with this. I looked at these in the store before I bought them. So there's two units. There's the Dewalt and this one. The Dewalt is a fantastic saw. I went and took a look at it, and I like this one too. Both of them are compact. They weigh roughly 50 pounds. And for me, I can just take this, throw it in my truck, and all this stuff is all self-contained, all underneath. Put it in the truck, away I go. And I like that. But like I say, when I phoned up Dewalt and they said it was, you know, quite a higher amperage. I mean, we're talking, you know, so high that my generator would probably not run it. I mean, when you go to the store and you're buying one of these things and you're running off a generator, don't expect to ask anybody in there at Home Depot or wherever you buy these things. This one here I bought off of Amazon. And I could have bought the Dewalt for less. The Dewalt was about $50 less. This was almost $400 plus tax. The Dewalt was about $50 less. And at Lowe's at the time was, you got an extra set of blades, Dewalt blades as well. But I know, I don't believe that I could run it off my generator. So that was the real crux of me getting this one. And for me, this is all that I need. It's nothing fancy, and I'm all for this kind of stuff. It comes with a blade already, a 10-inch carbide tip blade. And I'm curious, I don't know if you are, but I'm curious to see how many amps this will start up at. I hope I was given the right information, and we're going to find out. But yeah, I would have probably bought the Dewalt if it wasn't for the phone call that I made to Dewalt. And they said that this thing is going to start up at 45 amps. And if a lot of you have never owned a generator, I've owned many generators. And when you're going, you know, 15 amps past your maximum startup, it's never going to run. And in this particular situation, it's not 15 amps. We go from 38 amps to 45. But my running current is 15 amps on both of them. So my saw could run both of them running current, but it's the initial startup. A generator with the governor on it will not handle the initial startup on a lot of items. And sometimes they will, but the saw will not operate properly. And the saw engine life, not the engine, the motor life will probably be affected as well. So I like to stay within the limits of the manufacturer's recommendations. Let's throw the amp clamp on it. Let's take a look. But I'll show you first over here. I've got my Milwaukee chop saw. And I like to put a tag on everything that I use with my generator and measure the running amperage. So I'll show you my Milwaukee chop saw first to show you exactly what's a good tip to do. So when you grab a piece of equipment, you know what the startup current is. So let's take a look at that first.
Okay, so there we are right there. I better clean this up a bit for you here. There we are. So you could see right there, running amps 10, peak amps 17 to 20. So let's go over here and let's try it out on this new Bosch table saw.
Okay, so here we are. I got the amp clamp hooked up. And guys, I'll tell you what, in my experience, the amp clamp is a lot faster than the governor on a generator. So I'll start this up and we'll see how many amps it pulls. So let me just see if I can put all this in the same shot and we'll start her up. Guys, I seen about 14 amps there, 14 to 15 amps. I'm gonna get another meter, something that's a little bit faster than this, and let's see how close they were to 2,800 watts, or roughly 23 amps. So far, this is looking good. Let me get the other meter out. Okay, so let's try this one here, and let's see what this one shows. Okay, it looked like it was around 38, 39 amps. Let's get another meter and let's just check this out. I got an even faster one. So let's take a look and let's see what's going on here. Well, let's take another try at it here. I'll show you the setup I got here. And I got her hooked up to my amp clamp. Coming over here, and I got her set up on my Fluke 287. Guys, this is going to capture it like real fast. I'm kind of leaning that I wasn't told the right information, but I'm going to zoom you in on this. I can't get everything in the shot here, but you'll hear the table saw start up and let's take a look. Okay, so the scale on this is 1 millivolt is 1 amp. I'm going to restart it. So I got it stopped right here, close. I got it, so I'll restart it, and there we go. And let's see, it's just auto ranging right now, but let's take a look and see what that shows. Okay guys, now was that interesting or what? This is advertised as a 4 horsepower saw. Now the Dewalt does not advertise how many horsepower there is, but you can definitely see the difference between 2,800 watts and 23 amps. And the Dewalt telling me theirs is 5,400 watts and 45 amps on startup. I would say Dewalt was bang on. I really can't tell the difference. You know, I'm not an electrical engineer to tell the difference between what kind of a motor from one to another would make a huge difference like that between 2,800 and 54. But this does not start up, as far as I'm concerned, at 2,800 watts. It looks, you've seen on the screen there, and it's does look like it's a lot more than 2,800 watts. So I really don't know if this is going to run my generator. My generator maximum is 4550 and that's 38 amps. We're going to find out. You're going to have to wait till next summer to find out. But yeah, that's the kind of reviews I do, because I like to see whether the specifications that they're talking about are actually real or not. I don't know whether this is real and how fast, for how many milliseconds, they're getting their 2,800 watts out of. If any of you guys have better insight on how they would get that 2,800 watts from, I would be interested too, because for me, I'm not seeing the 2,800 watts or 23 amps. I'm seeing a lot more than that. And that's pretty well it for this review. To tell you the truth, it looks like the Dewalt probably was the better choice. In the beginning, I was strictly going off what I was told on the telephone. This does look like a nice saw though. I have to give them credit. This is put together really, really, really nice. Everything I know that Bosch does build is top notch. All I can do is let you know how it works out. Now, I really don't know what else to say on this vid, guys. It's one of these times where it goes sideways on you again. I really thought that 2,800 watts was the magic number, and of course we exceeded that quite a bit. So, thank you very much for joining in. If you haven't seen this channel before, you're welcome to subscribe. And let's come back again and have some more fun when this thing is actually running on my generator. And we're going to see if it runs it. Until then, guys, come back again. It's always a blast. Let's have some more fun. Bye, guys.